If you can't do it, that the thoughts of men traveled in her, and even though she wasn't real, and that she only weighed as much as a large balloon. At the market, the pita bread was being tested by the manager, who'd been told that surely it had too much bacon for the bad man who's picking some up for dinner. He decided to shine his pitas, and picked up his things, and headed to his cabin along the eastern shore. On the way, he saw what looked like a shortcut that he'd never seen before. So he took it. Once he started on the path, ahead he saw a coyote jump straight up into the air on his hind legs after a gray, gray bird. It didn't bother the man, but he walked forward with loud steps to let the coyote know not to think twice about an ambush. Finally, he came down the path to his home by the shore, and he saw the woman he'd fought for floating above the house on a piece of twine. She'd become so light, she could not touch the earth anymore. And there was the great gray bird, pecking away at the twine. Suddenly the twine gave way, and the woman floated up over the bay. The poor man, half crazed from his mind, grabbed his old .22 rifle to shoot her down. But when he'd shot, to his surprise, she turned into a seal and splashed down into the water. No wonder she'd always been so strange.
"I saw you move on,"
he said to himself. Now in the evening, you hear her singing to him. You can go down to the water to see. They'd always find a pile of fresh caught fish.
perch of the cloud. The blessing of our father was strangled when he awoke from his sleeping scarlet night shroud. And they say, soon will be the storm. And the storm will soon be here. We are now changed. Solidly we are water. Gaseous, I say. Gas are we, I fear. And he began as we, birthed from it. And he shall return as we to it. And it is on the moving. And he is on the moving. Our earth is moving yellow-green with this afternoon's approach of the rain. The ever-loving beauty of our mother is bursting throughout the confines of fungus, insect, crow, and grain. Insect and grain, fungus and crow. And here we got us an upright walker, a builder, a thinker, and a non-stop talker. And here our hands join their reflection on the still water. And here our eyes meet only along the inside boundary of our eyes' color. And here is the Cape of Holes cut rope sky song. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And here meet our eyes only along the inside boundary of our eyes' color. So God created man in his own image. And that's where our eyes meet only along the inside boundary of our eyes' color. In the twilight, the slow wailing of widowed seamen's wives will pull straining, suffocating ears upward and above. The solid waters that fill their chests with an endless chilled night. And together, out of the choking sobs of the women, emerges a sad, slowly drifting line, finally to escape from the sweet mouth of a chickadee as song. Slowly drifting line, emerging from the sweet mouth of a chickadee as song. The stratosphere, space inside our connected eyes. And our shared vision is that of the starlit skies. And the world is in moving on the backs of our eyes. And we know where and when the selfish tear dries. And we know where our immortality lies. And we know where and when the selfish tear dries, and we know where our immortality lies, in the starlit skies. It is in moving on the backs of our eyes. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female created he them. And we know where our immortality lies. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. And here meet our eyes only along the inside boundary of our eyes' color. And the world is in moving on the back of our eyes.
They were the five daughters of Mara, Lord of Darkness. They were the spirits of pride, greed, fear, ignorance, and desire. And Mara had sent them to tempt Siddhartha away from his search.
Thank you.
of life in the simplest forms. But Siddhartha was looking beyond form, beyond the present. And now Mara was enraged.
Judgment.